October 20th, 2020. We have a review of work session discussion meeting minutes. And no questions or concerns?
None here.
We'll move to department head report. Dan?
Had a meeting with Recreation and Tourism Director Tim Ishman Monday, and he expressed his concerns with, there are a couple shelters in Brady's Run Park that he wasn't able to rent this year simply because of, they're unsafe. You know, I think we've visited this in the past, in particular shelter number 4. He says that he has money in his budget this year and next year to have prefab shelters, for us to install prefab shelters. So what I'm looking for is permission to go in and raise 2 or 3 shelters in the park so that he can get those back on the books for rentals.
When he says they're unsafe, I don't doubt that, but what is it, why are they unsafe? Is it structural, is it the roof?
It's structural. These are actually the ones that a few years back that Widmer Engineers came in and looked at. And they were deemed. I mean, they could have fallen over. They said that they were okay for the time being, but couldn't guarantee that they were gonna stay safe. Our guys since then have gone and looked at them, and the main beams and things like that are rotting and deteriorating away.
Is the cement pad still?
Yeah, we reuse the cement pads.
Is it structural deficiencies?
Yes.
Did he give you a cost? I'm just curious what a prefab structural cost.
He didn't give me any numbers, man. I'm sorry.
I'm wondering how much he makes per rental.
I believe they're $40.
Yeah, so
to
how
rent.
Long does it recover, take to recover the prefab cost? Okay.
While we're on that subject, who's responsible for, my wife and I were there a couple of weeks ago, we took a tour around with the dogs and stuff. The number of dead trees that are along the walking paths and near the shelters and stuff, do we take those down? Do we hire somebody?
Well, if it's something that we can handle, you know, I mean,
there's a couple.
Especially if they're in open areas, if they're
not worried about the ones that are up in the woods, but especially along all the walking paths, from the lodge towards the horse arena area.
We have spent in the past, like last winter, we spent a lot of time around the walking loop, the walking circle, you know, removing dead trees and stuff. It's kind of like a winter project, you know. We'll get in there and do that. So
that one, you can see there's a lot of trees down, but I'm talking more where the shelters
and that. Yeah, that's something.
So I just have to notice now that the leaves are falling. So
we can spend some time doing things like that this winter.
Yeah, I don't think it's a high priority. I don't see anything that's imminent, but obviously there's, I mean, you could probably spend a month there trying to clean stuff up.
I know, and some of the stuff that's already down, Tim, myself, and Garen, we had conversations in the past of, you know, possibly doing something, but that kind of fell by the wayside. So I don't know where that's at right now. So,
I didn't know if when you said that whether it was unsafe from some of the trees surrounding some of those shelters. I don't know all the numbers, but just thought of that.
Yeah, that's definitely things that we take care of.
Okay.
Update on everything.
No,
I was gonna ask them down on the roof. Are they working?
They are supposed to, I believe this weekend they will be getting started.
Okay.
Yeah, this weekend is the date. We have scheduled weekly progress meetings, obviously. We met last week in the trailer. Nothing happened from then until now, so they'll be every Wednesday. Ronnie Kay from Constellation canceled this week's meeting because there's nothing new to report. So the roofing they're gonna get started, I believe, this weekend. And they wanted to, once again, they visited about bringing a crane in over on the area over by where the courts park and everything like that. No, so they wanted to do it Saturday as well. We moved the farmers market around there on Saturday, so they're going to do this on Sunday.
Okay.
they're gonna bring their crane in and start sending materials up on the roof on Sunday.
You gonna build the thing with the lights? Out front on the columns?
Yeah.
That, well, these guys did that, right?
Yeah, his staff did that.
I passed it on to Skip Matters, the gentleman that put the lights on yesterday.
Right.
I passed on to him, and he got it set by.
Yeah, no, it's all fixed, good things, so. Appreciate that.
It'd be nice around the holidays too, you could change those up and, you know, different colors and things, so.
Just two other things, I was also Richard Willard Crossing. Saturday looks great, really appreciate Willard got to talk to.
Yeah.
Our contractors, they did a nice job there.
Yeah, unbelievable the amount of progress they made in just a couple days, I was shocked.
You said yesterday they were in the hallway, you said they were down there again yesterday, doing more?
Yeah, with, you know, the pictures that I had sent, and that was, they was just done. All that area, I mean, as you could see, there was still dead stuff on you know, they're, that was all raked, prepped for soil,
They were spraying the rodeo stuff to make sure to get the Japanese knotweed roots and stuff.
There was some issue, like, those pine trees were so planted so close together that some of the ones that were left, there was dead. So I had asked him to trim up a couple feet so they would be uniform, to remove some of the dead stuff that was up against it. So he was going to do that, and then that would give access to, you know, be able to get underneath those trees better as well. And then some of the bushes that are around the first observation area there on the left, they were a little bit thick. So I asked him to remove a couple of those as well. So, coming along nice. I was surprised how fast, how much he got done in just 2 days.
I was surprised to see him there Saturday when I was there. And just one last thing for you, the HVAC bid process, you're satisfied with that?
Wayne and I will get, two that we figured. So I was a little bit surprised by the difference in the numbers, but Reno's came in, but I was
right.
Certainly confident.
Well, I think you have confidence in either one of them being capable of going.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, just want to make sure that was, so I know that's been an issue for a while.
Any other department head report? Any questions? We'll move to solicitor.
Nothing to report for the public portion of the meeting. We will need executive session to discuss personnel matters.
Any questions for the solicitor? Board of Commissioners, the only thing, go ahead.
Just wanted an update on the cafe contract. It really came to mind yesterday. We had a long day interviewing.
Yeah.
And
getting
to
be candy.
I put the machine kept rejecting my money. So fortunately, somebody went out and got me a hot dog. So it's important that we can get that expedited.
Especially with the cold weather. The gentleman who we met with, last week.
Garcia?
Christian Garcia. He called us up, needed to meet with us again. I typed him up a lease that was specific to him. He needed that, he said, for the insurance to issue the policy. He knows now that the next step is for him to actually obtain that policy, sign the lease, and then we'll present the signed lease. It still seems as though all systems are go with him. He requested to see the space one more time, take some measurements, so that's a good sign. So I think we're all on the same page that sooner rather than later is best. And he seems to share that. So that was just, what was that? Yesterday, so
yeah,
I expect to hear from him by the end of the week.
Okay. The only other thing I had was the CARE Act money, so I'm going to defer that to the chairman speak with my mouth.
So we are looking at the distribution of CARES Act money for the municipalities moving forward. The board was giving the request from municipalities. At this time, there has been 23 applications that were submitted, requested more than what they would be funded for by the calculations through ZNA. What the calculations were determined through population. There's $4 million divided by the population of the county, then there's a percentage of each municipality. For instance, I will just give one example, two examples. Aliquippa, this allotment would be $222,022. They've only requested $24,749. Ambridge allotment would be $165,846, but they have requested $720,000. So what we're preparing to do is start to notify the municipalities of the 30 that have submitted applications and say, this is what you're eligible for. You can come pick this check up pending the pending they're spending the money on what they should be spending on police.
Yeah, there's certain requirements that the money has to be spent on. One of the biggest budget items is anything that's associated with the police department. Salaries, benefits, wages for the police department is eligible to be used for the CARES Act funding. Any type of PPE equipment that was purchased, any type of other equipment, computers, plexiglass that was purchased under COVID, municipalities would be eligible in order to seek reimbursement for that. As Commissioner Camp said, we've received some requests from some municipalities that what they've requested is an amount higher than otherwise what they're going to get. So those municipalities, we will contact them and let them know what that check would be. There are some municipalities that requested an amount that's lower than what they're otherwise eligible to get. We're going to reach out to those municipalities and let them know that you're eligible to receive more amount of money if you can justify it. And you would have to submit that information to the county within 2 weeks. And then there's a third group that didn't submit anything at all. We're going to reach out to that group to let them know, hey, you're eligible for this amount of money, but you need to submit something to the county within 2 weeks that qualifies.
And I think what we plan on doing is the ones who do not submit anything, or for instance, if Aliquippa doesn't resubmit more expenditures, we're going to be putting that money back into the pot and redistribute it to the ones who are eligible, who are requesting more money. I do know that we had early discussions with the state and the federal government. There's a good chance come December 15th that we might be getting a redistribution of more money coming from the state, which only gives us around 30 days to spend that. We will hopefully be able to give more money to these municipalities through that process. But we want to make sure that we give all the municipalities a chance to gain some money. I mean, even the smaller ones, White Township is eligible for $32,000. They haven't applied for anything. So we're hoping that, by us reaching out to the municipalities here in the next couple of days, they'll start, get the ball rolling and find some expenditures. But as Solicitor Fidel said, any department, any municipality who has a police department is technically eligible and can use that money to fund their police department.
Or if they have a contract.
Yes, or if they have a contract,
but
yes.
They will have to have their own.
Vanport.
Anybody who has a contract for police coverage, so there's like seven of these states.
Yes.
They're all expensive, but it's anybody related to public safety, right? So.
Correct. So those expenses would qualify, that would allow you to submit an application.
Yeah, submit the application.
And then once you get that money, then in turn, that's up for the municipality to decide how they want to spend that particular amount of money.
The only other thing I have other than CARES Act, if we're going to move on, is just some election information. To date, there has been 35,391 mail-in ballots sent out, or applied and or sent out. 22,827 have been returned here to the courthouse via mail or in person. Early voting by mail-in ballot, the courthouse has ended as of yesterday. If you have a mail-in ballot and would like to turn in at the courthouse, you still can. If you've applied for a mail-in ballot and did not receive one, you can come to the courthouse and get your ballot, or it can be mailed to you. If you'd like to take your ballot to the polling, your polling place, because you'd like to vote at the poll now, what will happen is the judge of election will void your ballot, and you will do a new one. If you have destroyed your ballot and threw it away, you will vote by provisionary ballot. If you plan on turning a completed ballot in at the courthouse, so I complete it here or at the polling place, and I go to my polling place on November 3rd and want to give that, they will void that ballot. They will give you a new one, and you have to vote cast a new ballot there. You can come to the courthouse here on election day to turn your ballot in if you don't feel comfortable going to your polling center. All 129 polling places will be open. And the biggest question I think we're going to continue to get is Beaver County will not start opening and processing any mail-in ballots until Wednesday morning, November 4th. So we will have some election results on November 3rd, the ones who cast it at the polling centers, but any mail-in ballot, none of them will be starting to be processed until November 4th, the morning of. And then that's all I have for my commissioner.
Yep, just a couple of things. Holly Boyd and I visited Pitmoss in Ambridge. We're trying to work with them. You know, we have our compost field and stuff, which is kind of competing material for what Pitmoss does, which is a recycled paper mulch that is better than most compost and some other things. So we're looking for a collaborative arrangement with them and some of the stuff that Holly does for the schools to do that. But one thing that I learned yesterday in that visit that peat moss itself, which has to be dug up out of the ground, it's several hundred years old moss. Most of it's imported from Canada. When you go to plant a tree and they give you, you know, that bag of peat moss, that's the equivalent of burning 22 pounds of coal. In terms of carbon release, when does it? I had no clue about that. They'd kind of like us to work on a collaborative environmental approach to avoid using peat moss if we can use compost from our fields or the peat moss material. So it's something they may come back and ask us to kind of have Beaver County be one of the first peat-free zones. And when we do plantings and stuff, use either pit moss or the compost stuff rather than having that contractor go and use imported peat moss from Canada. So something for us to just kick around that I thought was interesting. And with the bags and blessings stuff, there's been a great effort here on that process between Conservation District, Record Tourism, and the county. And your folks at Dan working on that, and they'll start planting trees in the spring to repopulate Brady's Run originally, where there's dead trees there and memories of different folks. So another great community initiative that it's a nice collaborative arrangement there. So I'd like to thank Robin, Deputy Robin Redfern for that effort. And that's it, other than some personnel issues. So.
Any questions or anything else? We'll move to other business. The only other business that we would have is work session for Wednesday, November 4th is canceled, will be canceled. Day after election, we always seem to cancel it. There's, especially this year with opening the ballots, there's gonna be a lot going on here at the courthouse. So that's the only other business and announcement. So we'll move to audience participation.
A couple questions. On that, November 11th is supposed to, right? So that work session. Right?
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry.
Is
that a Wednesday? November?
Yes.
Thank you.
But the question on the CARES money. So the $4 million, you've allotted $4 million to the municipalities, and you're going to try your best to get all that money out to municipalities. If it keeps coming back first run, but the $4 million you guys have said you want to
get. It's all going to go out. Because,
okay.
For instance, we have quite a few municipalities that have asked or requested more,
gotcha.
That are eligible for more, too. So no matter what, that $4 million is going to be sent out, hopefully, by.
Yeah, and I think that's one thing we want to get with you. I know your check runs are sort of off in November. When would we be able to put a check run together to get these checks out from municipalities? Because that might dictate what we put in this letter.
If we know ahead of time, we work with Sandy, we can do it off of a day too, just so we know. We just can't get them and process them within like 24, 36 hours. But if we plan for it, we can sit down and look at our calendar and say, when do you think? And let's plan a day and we'll know it's coming. So we can do it an off day.
I think the critical item for us is all these municipalities are working on their budgets right now.
Yeah. They wanna know.
Well, I would like to know, you know, we.
Yeah, so when will you guys be ready to give us a list?
We can give you a list of some of them right now.
We can start.
At least of what they're eligible for.
Yeah, and even we could start and print those and just hold them, right? So we can have it all together, but we can process.
About half of them, we can tell you the exact figure right now.
There's 23 of them that requested more funding than what we're giving them, so those could, the first wave of checks can start going out.
To them, yeah.
Yeah.
We can start processing.
There's seven that requested less than what they're receiving, so we're gonna reach out to them and say, hey, you're could receive more funding, would you like to, or would you like us to redistribute that to the other municipalities? And there's 23 that haven't submitted any.
So we can at least get those 23 out to what they can get.
And so to Caltori, I think what we'll do is we'll do the same things that we did for the businesses, that we would have them come here to sign to pick up the check, and there's paperwork that they're gonna have to sign. So I think what we can do is we can work with the controller's office as far as for those 23, getting those checks printed, getting a notification out to those municipalities that they are eligible. And then the other ones, I think we were thinking of a 2-week deadline. So we probably were looking at, I guess, November 13th, which is
how could we throw out the 15th or so?
The only thing I ask is when we plan it, let's do a pickup date after the date we print checks if we can.
Let me do that.
But yeah, we can get together. I can get with Tony and we can look at a calendar. We can figure out what works.
Yeah.
And even set up some tentative ones for the other rounds.
So with this next wave, though, there's going to have to probably be a period of time that Zelenkovsky and Axelrod reviews what's submitted. So if we give them to the 13th to submit stuff, which would be 2 weeks from Friday, then
right.
Zelenkovsky and Axelrod is probably going to take a week or so in order to submit or review what it is that they submit to make sure that it is eligible. And then from there, we'd have to give a figure. So
there aren't that many, right? We're talking about like it's not like we're talking many.
Yeah.
So we should be.
We're talking about 30. Yeah, 30.
Yeah. I mean, we'd love to be able to say that every municipality, every resident got something back.
But if they can't spend on COVID stuff, then they can't use it, right? So there's no obligation.
I would still think that most, yeah. I mean, it's hard for me to imagine.
It's nice
that
the contracts, right?
They don't have something, at least with the police contracts.
That's
and some other things.
Like people like industry and Vanport can now use it for their contracts,
yeah.
Right? So there's
other stuff. Absolutely.
The one other question I have, do we have an update on where they are on the reassessment? I know last time I heard it was Rochester and stuff, have they moved on?
It's the economy.
Yeah,
they're
in
London.
Thank you.
Industry down the block. If you know anyone in
industry. Yeah, I do. I'll call it.
Just in case.
Just in case.
I think Rochester has extra, and they didn't put enough in.
Rochester has
another boat.
Is Rochester under?
Rochester, yeah, Rochester Borough.
They were a very late entrant.
Yeah, they requested $246,000. They're eligible for $86,000. And the township is the same. They requested 155 and they're eligible for 65. So they're both probably last day entries. But, so.
I think it was over 7 million, just in the wrong numbers.
Yeah.
That was submitted from those municipalities.
And most of them were.
Some of them have some
police
departments, right?
Yeah.
You know?
And in Rochester's case, like, why am I submitting? I'm like, because the money's there and you need it. Why not take it?
Yeah.
I mean, you guys need help.
Yeah, and they changed that last minute, correct?
Yeah, there was a lot of confusion as far
with
whether the
law
police
enforcement,
whether there was eligibility or not. And then we got a clarification there late in the process that police departments are eligible just in what you pay in their salary, regardless of if they did anything with COVID or not.
How many if they actually spent?
Prior to that, we weren't sure how much money was going to be able to be given to the municipalities because you can only buy so many laptops and plexiglass shields.
Yeah,
it's only
going to
be $5,000, $10,000, then that's why we're starting to see the larger numbers because it's definitely the ones the larger police departments are submitting. So, any other audience participation?
Last week, Commissioner Manning had mentioned about a phone call from the Department of Agriculture. I was notified yesterday that the Department of Agriculture will not be reimbursing the county when we send out our dog license renewals this year. That is about $3,500 for my office, and I do believe that I can stretch that up in my budget this year, but we'll have to plan for next year. The department has said that they
because the program's insolvent, which is why they're pushing for the passage of those bills, right?
And I'm not quite sure how that happened. I'm thinking that there's a little bit of mismanagement at the Department of Agriculture.
In Harrisburg?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Shop.
Yeah. So we pay the department about $90,000 this year, just in tax. And that's not talking about any fines that we issue. It's a $300 fine if you do not have your dog licensed. So they should be okay.
Yeah. Frustrating, but thank you.
Dan?
The departmental and office request for the CARES Act for right here in Beaver County, have they been approved or any word on those?
Corey, after we determine this $4 million, we can start looking at the bigger requests that were done.
He has the list of, he hasn't given them to us yet. I haven't seen them.
He's breaking out all the big requests that as a part of that.
So if, in the meantime, if we need masks or, you know, something like that,
you could use cost center, the cost center set up in New World, and then we'll make that transfer.
All right, thank you.
Any other audience participation? Hearing none, we need to reconvene. We'll move into executive session, not reconvene.